students. Today we'll begin with a new chapter, and the name of chapter is circles. So next we'll start question number 8 of exercise 2.4. So I'll mention that also. Exercise 2.4, MSP, question number 8. Exercise is 2.4, 8 sir. Question goes this way. There are two circles. Smaller one and bigger one. These two circles have a common tangent. So I've drawn a common tangent also. This is how one line is drawn over this side and the second line. This point of intersection is B and other side is C. So this is your B, this is your C. Name of the triangle is, this is how figure is named, ACB, ACD and B. Now it is given to us, CD is a common tangent. CD is a common tangent, that is known to us. We need to prove angle CAD plus angle CBD equals to 180 degree. So CD is a common tangent, two figures are drawn, B is the point of intersection for both the triangles and centers are also marked but not named. Now this angle which I have marked in yellow, if you apply angles in alternate segment, you will observe that in this line is a tangent and BC is a secant. BC is a secant and CD is a tangent. So this angle, if we make a construction of joining A and B, the angle which I have marked with yellow will equal to the angle which I have marked over here. Angles in alternate segment, I can call both angles as XX because both are equal. Same way in a bigger triangle, in a bigger circle rather, this line is a tangent and this line is a secant. Again, in a bigger circle, CD is a tangent. So, this line is a secant. So, angle in alternate segment, this will be the angle. So, we can call this angle as Y. This angle will also be Y. So, I'll start with the proof of this. Construction is, we are joined A and B. Proof: BC, secant, CD, tangent. This is for a smaller circle. For a smaller circle, I can call BC secant, CD is a tangent. These two things are given to us. Therefore, angle, we can say angle BCD equals to angle CAB. Reason, angles in alternate segment. Same way, for a bigger circle, I can write for a bigger circle. We can make out BD is a secant and CD is a tangent. Therefore, angle BDC congruent to angle DAB.
So we are calling this as X, this as Y, reason is same, angle is in alternate segment. We can call this as first equation, this as second equation. This is your second equation. Now in this triangle, sum of these three angles 180 degree, same way. In triangle BCD also, sum of three angles 180 degree. So I can write, in triangle BCD, sum of three angle 180, so angle CBD plus angle BCD plus angle BDC equals to 180 degree. Sum of measure of angles of the triangle is 180 degree. Reason for this? Therefore, angle CBD plus, now instead of BCD, we can write angle CAB, plus, instead of BDC this time, we can write angle DAB, becomes 180 degree. We got this from first and second. This we will call equation number third. Now look at angle CAB and look at angle DAB. Angle CAB, angle DAB. If you add these two angles, you will get angle CAD. What is the reason? Reason is angle addition property. We can add two angles. That is how we have got this angle. Now, third and fourth equation. Angle CAB, angle DAC. Angle CAB, angle DAC. Instead of these two angles, I can replace by angle CAD. Therefore, result is angle CAB plus angle CAD equals to 180 degree. This we got from third and fourth. So, in a sum where we have a tangent, we have a secant, we can make out, we can apply angles in alternate segment theorem. These two angles congruent. We have named it by X to ensure that things becomes easier. We can identify very easily if you name it by X. Same way for Y also. We could have replaced values by X and Y also. But this time it was more appropriate to directly put the values. So only construction we have done was AB was joined. Rest by applying property of a triangle which says sum of three angles 180 degree. We have replaced angles. So this was there. Instead of these two, we wrote these two angles. But these two angles becomes angle CAD. Next we'll start 9th sum of exercise 2.4. So in the sum, there are two circles which are touching each other externally. So I'm drawing two circles. This line is a common tangent for both the circles. Common tangent. And from point A, this is your point A, from point A, there is a line drawn which is going through both the circles. This side is point C, and from this vertex also there is a line drawn which is touching the bigger circle. Point C is there. And this side point B is there. So point D, I'll name it name now. B, point M, point C. This is your point C. And B, other points are A, P and E. Point A, center is P. Point E and point Q. This side center is point Q. this is how the figure is now. So given to us, P and Q are centers, they are touching each other at point A. The extended chord AB intersects circle with center P in point E, and the chord BC touches the circle with center P at point D. That is also shown to prove AD, to prove ray AD is an angle bisector. AD is an angle bisector for angle CAE. This is your angle CAE. We need to prove. This is your point C. We need to prove AD is the angle bisector. In other words, we need to prove these two angles are equal. Angle CAD, congruent angle DAC. Which side is the proof of this? Now these two angles we need to prove congruent. You can make out triangle DAB in triangle DAB or BAD. Angle DAE is an exterior angle. How it happens? Just have a look. Triangle, one side extended, this becomes exterior angle. And we all know this exterior angle is equal to sum of two remote interior angles. So in triangle BAD, this is your triangle. You can make out angle DAE. Angle DAE is an exterior angle. Exterior angle is formed when one of a side is extended in a straight way, in a straight line. BA is extended in a straight way, in a straight line. So angle DAE becomes an exterior angle. Therefore, angle DAE equals to, so angle DAE becomes sum of two remote interior angles. Exterior angle is equal to sum of two remote interior angles. So angle DAE becomes sum of two remote interior angles. That is your angle D plus angle B. Equation number one. Remote interior angle theorem. After this, point M is an outside point. From point M, we are drawing two tangents. Right? From point M, we are drawing two tangents. MD is equal to MA. Tangent segments from exterior point are congruent. So MD is equal to MA. This is the reason for it. Now MD is equal to MA. Therefore, we can write angle D congruent to angle MAD. Angles opposite to congruent sides. When sides are equal, angles are equal, isosceles triangle theorem. This is our second equation. Angle D is equal to angle MAD. So I'll mark these two equations. Same way, if you look at this side, this line is a tangent, this line is a secant, again, this line is a tangent, this line is a secant. Angle which is formed, angles in alternate segment. So I'll write the reason for it. Reason is MA tangent. MC, MA tangent, AC, secant. Therefore, we can write angle MAC is equal to angle B, equation number 3, angles in alternate segments we have done this theorem, angles in alternate segment theorem. So we got MAC is equal to angle B. Now if you look at equation number 1 and 2, equation 1 says angle DAE is equal to D plus B, equation 2 says angle D is equal to MAD, equation 3 says angle B is equal to MAC. Therefore from 1 to 3 I can write angle DAE is equal to, so I am replacing angle D by angle MAD and I am replacing angle B by MAC. So we got angle DAE is equal to angle MAD plus angle MAC. The reason for this is three equations which we have formed. We are calling this as fourth equation now. Also, you just have to look at the figure now. Angle MAD. This is your angle MAD. Angle MAC. This is your angle MAC. Now if I add these two angles, don't you think I'll get angle CAD? Angle addition property. MAD plus angle MAC is equal to angle CAD. Equation number 5. Reason is angle addition property. We got fifth equation. Now look at fourth and fifth. Fourth says angle DAE is equal to MAD plus angle MAC, but angle MAD plus angle MAC is CAD. Result is these two are equal. Therefore, angle DAE congruent to angle CAD. This is from fourth and fifth. Again, we have to look at the figure. Angle DAE. Angle CAD, both are equal. That means we got this result. Now, if these two angles are equal, by definition of angle bisector, AD becomes what? Angle bisector. Therefore, AD is an angle bisector. For which angle? CAE, angle bisector of angle CAE. This is what our answer is. So what we have done? First, remote interior angle theorem. Second, isosceles triangle theorem. Third, angles in alternate segment. Fourth, angle addition. So we'll start question number 10 of problem set. In this sum, figure I have already drawn. There are two circles given to you. These two circles are intersecting at point A and B. Through A, there is a secant drawn, which is intersecting one of the circle in point R, S. Again, one more line is drawn, which is intersecting one of the circle in point P, and another circle in point Q. There are two things which we need to prove. First one, angle PTQ plus angle PBQ is equal to 180 degree. The second part, BSTR, quadrilateral, BSTR, we need to prove it is a cyclic quadrilateral. So two answers we need to get. Now you can make out in the sum, there is a triangle and angle PTQ is nothing but angle T of that triangle. What we'll do to get the answer for first one, we are going to apply the property of a triangle which says that sum of three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So in this triangle there are three angles,
this is your angle R, this is your angle S.
So, to get angle PBQ, I need to join PB, I need to join BQ. So, I got angle PBQ now. Also, I need to join AB. So, AB also I have joined. To get quadrangle BSTR, we need to join BS. So, I am joining BS also. BS is also joined. So, I write the construction part. Construction, join PB, BQ, BS and AB. Proof of this. In triangle TRS, sum of three angles of a triangle 180 degree. Therefore, in triangle TRS, this is your angle T, right? Now, this angle T, we can name it as angle PTQ also. Angle PTQ. Why PTQ? Because the first answer, what we need to get is in terms of PTQ. So, in triangle TRS, angle PTQ plus this angle, angle TRS. Third angle is this one, angle TSR is equal to 180 degree. This is our first equation. Reason is sum of the angles of triangle 180 degree. Now, angle TRS is this angle. We know exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Over here, these four points are coincyclic points because all four points are on a circle, right? These four points are coincyclic. Now, when I have explained you cyclic quadrilateral, I have told you if all four points of a quadrilateral lies on a circle, that becomes a cyclic. So, point A, B, P, R, as from the figure we can make out, these four points lie on a circle. Therefore, quadrilateral A, B, P, R becomes cyclic. Why cyclic? Because points are coincyclic. Students, it is very important. Had it been given that ABPR is cyclic, we could have directly written ABPR cyclic. But in a question, there is nowhere mentioned that ABPR is cyclic. So we have to mention that these points lie on a circle. That is why it becomes cyclic by definition of cyclic quadrilateral. So ABPR cyclic. Therefore, now in a cyclic quadrilateral, exterior angle is equal to angle opposite to its adjacent interior angle. Exterior angle, interior angle, opposite to interior angle. Again, exterior angle, interior angle, this angle is opposite to interior angle. That means these two angles are equal. So angle TRS equals to angle, which angle? Angle ABP. This is our second equation. Reason, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral. This is your third angle of a triangle TRS. Triangle TRS, third angle TSR. Also, we can make out this angle is congruent to this angle. How many of you can guess the reason? There is a reason for it. I can't just tell you that these two angles are equal without any reason. These two angles are equal by angles inscribed in a same arc. Also, this angle is TSR, angle TSR equals This angle is ABQ. Angle ABQ. Third equation, reason, angles inscribed in same arc. So we got third equation, TSR congruent to angle ABQ. Now, if I use 1, 2, 3, this angle TRS can be written as angle ABP. This angle TSR can be written as angle ABQ. So I am using 1, 2, 3. Therefore, I can write angle PTQ plus replacement instead of TRS, angle ABP. And instead of TSR, angle ABQ is equal to 180 degree. This will write as equation number 4. How we got this? From 3 equations. Now, look at angle ABP plus angle ABQ. These two angles, angle ABP, angle ABQ, if you add, you will get angle PBQ. Equation number 5. Reason is angle addition. We have added two angles. Now look at 4th and 5th. Angle ABP, angle ABQ gives you angle PBQ. Result is angle PTQ plus angle PBQ, 180 degree. This is our answer. How we got this? From 4th and 5th. From using 4th and 5th equation, we can write angle PTQ plus angle PBQ is equal to 180 degree. So simple sum. Things which were used to get the answer. Property of a triangle which says sum of three angles 180 degree. Then after that, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Angles inscribed in a same arc. Angle addition property. Okay. So by now, you must be familiar, you must have understood. Every time to solve a problem, we have to bank on theorems, we have to bank on properties. And these properties are those properties which we have just done before the sums. So you can understand the importance of properties and theorems. So you need to remember all these things. Then only you can get the answers. We'll take one more sum. This is question number, problem set, question number 12 sum it is. So I'll write the problem number also. Problem set, question number 12. Problem set, 12 sum. So we'll just discuss first what all is given to us. Given to us, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. That means all the four vertices are on a circle. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Then AB and BC, AB and BC, these two lines intersect at point F. AD and BC intersect at point E. Then question is, show that circumcenters of triangle BCF, this is your triangle BCF, circumcircles of triangle BCF and triangle CDE intersect in point G on line EF. So I'll repeat this question again. हम लोगों को दिया हुआ है ABCD एक cyclic quadrilateral है. ABCD एक cyclic quadrilateral है. ये cyclic quadrilateral में जब मैंने AB और CD को extend किया तो point F में meet कर रहा है. वैसे ही BC और AD को extend किया तो point E में meet कर रहा है. Right? उसके बाद ये point B, C और F के ऊपर मैंने एक circle बना दिया. Please understand the question. फिर उसके बाद ये पॉइंट ई सी और डी के ऊपर भी मैंने एक सर्कल बना दिया. अभी क्या हो गया है, दो सर्कल बन गए हैं. क्वेश्चन दिया हुआ है ये दोनों सर्कम सर्कल जो हैं, ये दोनों सर्कम सर्कल पॉइंट जी पर मीट कर रहे हैं एफ ई के ऊपर. वंस अगेन द एंटायर क्वेश्चन, because this sum is very important. You have to conceptualize this sum. There is a figure given this way. ABCD cyclic है. ये cyclic है मतलब इसके चारों point circle के ऊपर है. AB और CD को मैंने extend किया, point F आ गया. BC और AD को extend किया, point E आ गया. तो अभी ये B, C और F on these points I have drawn a circle which is called as circumcircle. Same way on point C, D, E के ऊपर भी मैंने एक circle draw किया, circumcircle. अभी ये दो circumcircle बन गए हैं. उनमें पॉइंट जी आ गया. प्रूफ करना है पॉइंट जी इज ऑन ई एफ. इन अदर वर्ड्स वी नीड टू प्रूव एफ जी ई. हम लोग को प्रूफ करना है ये पॉइंट जी एफ ई के ऊपर आ रहा है. एफ ई के ऊपर कभी आएगा? जब ये स्ट्रेट लाइन होगी. इन अदर वर्ड्स वी नीड टू प्रूव इट्स अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. क्लियर? द क्वेश्चन इज वी नीड टू प्रूव इट्स अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. Construction, we are joining C and G. Join, CG, join. This is a construction. Now, this is a cyclic quadrilateral which is known to us. Proof of this, we'll start with this one. Points B, C, G, F are coincyclic points. Again, understand this. When I say circumcircle, that means points are on a circle. So these three points are on a circle. This is your fourth point. This is also on a circle, but we need to prove it's a straight line, right? So these four points are coincyclic. That means they are on a circle. The result is quadrilateral B, C, G, F becomes cyclic. By definition of cyclic quadrilateral, if the vertices are on a circle, the figure is a cyclic figure. So BCGF is a cyclic quadrilateral. Now when BCGF is a cyclic quadrilateral, you'll observe the angle formed over here. The angle formed over here. This angle, opposite this angle, right? So these two angles will be equal. Same way, this angle, opposite angle, this angle will be equal. You're getting it? So we have got this figure to be cyclic. So I can write the result this way. Angle formed over here is congruent to angle formed over here. This angle congruent to this angle, right? So we can say that this angle equals to this angle.